It had all the hallmarks of the lock her up refrain from the 2016 election. And now as then, many, if not all, Republicans are rallying behind the commander-in-chief, painting his words as ideological more than anything else from the beginning of the affair.
I think the president is in a tug-of-war with his opponents. If you're a Somali refugee and you're wearing a MAGA hat and you're a big Trump fan, you'd probably be having dinner at the White House. So he lashes out at people who are critical of him and his view that are hurting the country, and that's what this is all about.
Criticism from the Democrat camp, though, has been unanimous.
This is not just about threats to individual members of Congress, but it is about creating a volatile environment in this country through violent rhetoric that puts anyone like Ilhan, anyone who believes in the rights of all people, in danger.
The national atmosphere, however, is unlikely to be much on Donald Trump's mind. Instead, he seems to be looking towards next year and the presidential election.
This is the strategy that Trump is using. He doesn't believe that any Democrats are going to vote for him in 2020. And among independents, people that go back and forth, more of them are going to vote Democratic than Republican next time. So his chance of being reelected is to get a super turnout from his base, white conservatives, particularly non-college educated white conservatives.
Just how viable that strategy is in the long term, however, even if he gets elected, remains to be seen. Sheer demographics are against it, with younger voters much more unlikely to vote for a Republican Party they see as tarnished in the future.